such a great thing going. It's actually only dumb because they're friends.
Mm-hmm.
Like, if her friends gotta be single, then she's gotta be single too. It's like she wanted to, conform!
Sure.
Conformity, that's, that's why it happened.
Think that's the only thing, buddy?
Hell, you tried to oblige.
Nothing, Joe.
He looks like you wanna say something.
Look, man, I got a long night ahead of me. Can.
No, yeah, I'm scared. Yeah, sure thing. Sure thing.
Honestly, I don't have the time, you know, I gotta work on my lip finally. And, you know, yeah, I'm like a bit tired, but I'll be fine.
No, Anthony, that is not fine at all. When was the last time you took one?
Like 3 days, dude, alright? Like, calm down, I'll be okay.
No, Anthony, that is not good at all. You
need to take it now. You can't go.
Sleep is a vital aspect of human existence. The strange ritual of laying unconscious and defenseless for hours on end is never questioned, for science tells us sleep is, in fact, more important for the human body than food or water. In today's lecture, witness a world where the very practice of sleep has been privatized as a for-profit industry. Just as a plastic bottle transports a drink, in this small pill lies 8 hours of a good night's rest. Without this mere pill, who knows what dangers the mind would be left exposed to throughout a long night of insomnia. Is this the future, an alternate reality, or is it simply an occurrence on floor 13?
Thank you.
thought you were asleep. You'll be all right, buddy. Just get out of your system. You'll be okay. Hey, Joe?
Hey bro, just checking in to make sure you... Huh. Man's
looks like I've done my job.
Anthony Scarlatti, the subject of our lecture, a young man looking to do no more than complete his responsibilities as efficiently as humanly possible. In the process, he learned the difficulty of breaking the bond of accepted, albeit unjust, rules established long before his time, a time and place precisely constructed for our analysis on Floor 13.